So a large part of the job of an archivist, whether it's working with nitrate film or anything in our collection, is to conserve it. And that means making sure it's kept in proper conditions, making sure that we are checking it for degradation. For nitrate film, that's taken to 3 or 4 steps beyond that. There's both a legal requirement that we monitor it, but it's also our responsibility to preserve the original elements as long as possible, because those will be the highest quality elements that there are. We are now moving to digitally preserving all of the nitrate. The difference between what we are getting on a 6K scan and what we can get off of later film copies that were made is night and day. Anytime we can save the original, we're going to do that, and we're going to work from that. Nitrate film was replaced with safety film, was pretty much completely replaced in motion picture films by 1951. The reason for that was it has quite a reputation for being dangerous, and the idea was we don't want this in our archive. What would be done was a copy would be made of it onto a safety stock, later on onto a video of some kind, and then the original would be destroyed in some way, often burning it, because then you get the silver out of it. And you can get, you know, a fair bit of silver out of a reel of film. People used to do that in the early days where they're like, this is just disposable. Who's gonna wanna see this after everyone around here has seen it? So just burn it and get the silver out of it. New Zealand was actually the end of the distribution line for film in that era. So they would be given instructions to destroy the film. Sometimes people would do that, but oftentimes people would want to save it. Projectionists would squirrel it away somewhere, and then it would eventually make its way to us. As a result, we have an amazing collection of both New Zealand-produced and international film. Because people were concerned that this was such a dangerous thing and they didn't want it anywhere near them, they would often destroy the reels afterward and figure, this is the most modern of technology, VHS, it's where it's at. We are never going to want to copy this again. Well, what we've learned is that there's always a new technology around the corner. We think we're at the pinnacle right now. No, it's going to be something else. We're going to be scanning them to crystals at some point. Saving the original, which is always going to be the highest quality, is of paramount importance. There was a rallying cry in about 1980. It was nitrate won't wait, with the argument that by the year 2000, all of the nitrate will have degraded or been copied and gotten rid of. That has proven not to be the case. In fact, nitrate film is a lot more resilient than the safety film that was developed to replace it. We are finding that properly stored and maintained and taken care of, it could long outlast a lot of the other things in our collections. It'll outlast a digital file that you've lost off of your hard drive. It'll outlast a magnetic tape that was only designed to last for 10, 15 years. We're incredibly lucky that in New Zealand, that was not the approach that most museums, archives, collectors took. Instead, copied it, stored it away nicely.
In my job doing cataloging, I'll often watch movies, home movies or feature films that have been made, but they've already been digitized and I'm watching them on a computer screen. It's a whole different feeling to actually see the physical reel that contains that movie. I think remembering that these things are physical objects is really important and kind of part of their magic. It's not just about their content, it's about the carrier as well. The medium is the message. These aren't just records of people's birthday parties or a film someone made. They are records of how things get made, what technologies used to exist, the skills that are perhaps becoming obsolete or already have become obsolete. They tell bigger stories than just what they record.